Saanich North and the Islands.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. The good news is that public transit in the Greater Victoria area is heavily used and ridership is growing, keeping pace with population growth at about 1% per year. The bad news is that service hours have only been increased a total of 1% from 2010 until today. So wait times are increasing much faster than ridership at 3% per year. There is inadequate service for students and late night users. HandyDART demand from some of our most vulnerable citizens is not being met. Madam Speaker, on the Saanich Peninsula, there are large gaps in transit service. There is no direct service for the thousands of workers commuting to the Sydney industrial area every day. There is no direct service to the Victoria Airport, spotty service for four First Nations, and in the John Dean area, hundreds of households have no transit at all. Madam Speaker, the environmental, social, and business case for improved public transit could not be stronger. Improved transit is essential if we're going to meet our climate action goals. It also addresses affordability challenges for families, allowing them to reduce costly automobile use and even give up their cars altogether. And let's not forget the jobs, Madam Speaker. Public transit in Greater Victoria alone, including HandyDART, provides almost 1,000 well-paid jobs. The social benefits of transit are often overlooked, Madam Speaker. For many citizens who either cannot afford or cannot operate vehicles, public transit is the only way for them to get to work or to access services. Madam Speaker, the benefits of public transit are well established. There is clear evidence of unmet demand. So the question is, Madam Speaker, given the compelling environmental, social, and economic benefits of public transit, why have service levels in the Greater Victoria area been essentially frozen for 7 years? Thank you.